been a long 2 months since we announced that we'll have the Ask the Entrepreneur Forum. It's been 2 months since we asked you, members of the 360 Degrees Network, to nominate who the top entrepreneurs are. And I'm so excited to have them in front of you. I would like a round of applause for these very important people. Thank you very much for honoring our invitation. I would like right now to introduce Mr. Arinaitwe Rugyendo, who is the advertising director at the Red Paper, Paper Publications. He's not here just because he can talk. He's here in his own right as an entrepreneur because he's among the 5 young men that in 2001 started a newspaper that was supposed to fail and didn't fail it. And we think anybody better to ask the questions to the people who are very good at business, because these guys are worth billions of dollars. So we are happy to ask them how they make that kind of money. So Mr. Arinaitwe Rugyendo, over to you. Thank you very much, everyone, for coming. We are really honored to have you here. Thank you.
Thank you, David. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How are you? Oh, you're scared I have a camera here and you're going to have problems with red paper. Okay, today we are here for serious business. We are here to learn how to make money, and that's all. Simple and straight. I'm honored to moderate this show because, first of all, like I've been introduced, I'm one of the young entrepreneurs in Uganda. I'm into media entrepreneurship. And I've been introduced, you've heard about Red Paper and what it does. And very soon I think our people will be digitally showing you what we do. We all know why we're here. Simple, the 360 Network has this forum as one of those series of forum that they normally come up with every 2 months to interact with us, to enable us interact with each other, because we are virtual people on Facebook, but we never get that chance to be able to interact physically and share, have fun, look at opportunities, see how to exploit them and become much, much, much better. I think that's the reason we're here. And for tonight, we are only honored to handle one of those topics that are crucial to our own well-being, because we all aspire to be big people. We aspire to make something. We aspire to create a job wherever we are. I know most of you have jobs, but most of you won't run out of those jobs and start something. Others are tired at their businesses because they're not moving. So it's only an opportunity like this that we are able to connect the dots and understand how best to make ourselves better and make our businesses better. So I cannot be honored anymore than having this distinguished panel with me here. Most of them, if not all, are my personal friends, and I'm greatly honored, guys, to share with you tonight. I want to introduce them first and foremost before going any further. I will start to my immediate left. We have Mr. Patrick Bitature. Mr. Patrick Bitature is a big name. All of you know, have heard about Simba Telecom and stuff like that. Patrick, I'm glad to meet you here. Finally, sit down with you because you're one of the people who have inspired me. Next, we have Robert Ahimbisibwe. Robert Ahimbisibwe trades in suits. This is the brain behind Select Garments. Thank you, Robert, for coming. I'm happy to be with you here, and I think I can testify that this suit is Select Garment. To my immediate right, before I introduce Sylvia Owori, there is always this stereotype that business is a male-dominated area. It's only guys who can do business. Even women can do business. And Sylvia has epitomized the knack, the tenacity to do business as a woman. And for me, I credit her for one thing, for revolutionizing fashion in Uganda. Fashion was thought before to be something for the immoral people, the people who don't understand how to dress properly in an African tradition. But she has revolutionized that, and everybody out there thinks that fashion makes money. And we cannot have any more person than Sylvia Owori from Sylvia Boutique and African Woman. Thank you for coming, Sylvia. When I was starting Red Paper with my colleagues, I was chatting with these people who were coming here. That's in 2001. Sylvia came to fight me. She came looking for who the hell is Rugyendo, and I was at the reception, very small, and I told her, please, I don't know where Rugyendo is. And she ran away, furious about one of the stories we had published. But now I'm here. You're free to fight me, Sylvia. And finally, the big name. I want to welcome you, my friend, and one of the biggest entrepreneurs in Uganda, Mr. Sudhir Ruparelia. Mr. is now Dr. Sudhir Ruparelia. Sudhir is synonymous with money. I can't say anything else. And when I was coming, you know, he looks scared. You see him, guys. Sudhir told me, you know, Rugyendo, this is the first time I am addressing a public function. You guys are lucky to hear from Sudhir, because the only small thing I can say about Sudhir is that he's a generous man. Sudhir, I'm happy to see you here, and thanks for coming. Now, this evening and this session is not academic. It's not a lecture. It's not an academic lecture. This is not a university. We are here to understand simple things that make us money. And when we invited these colleagues of ours, they were asking me whether they're supposed to make a presentation, whether they're supposed to do a PowerPoint presentation. I told them that's not necessary. The people you see here, ladies and gentlemen, on this panel, are people who are aspiring to be like you, Patrick. Patrick, by the way, I didn't even mention something else. He's the chairman of Uganda Investment Authority, and that's very important. You have a crisis in this country, Patrick. People don't have jobs. People are aspiring to make jobs, but they don't have capital. You need to tell us where to get that capital from. And at the same time, most of these people want to improve on their small businesses and make them as big as you, as yours. So it's the reason we have this gathering here. And the style is going to be question and answer. We ask you a question and you answer it. From this point, I'm going to ask Sudhir, but if I ask you, I think I'll give you a chance as chairman of businesses in this country to open this discussion. There's one fundamental question that's been asked here, that what are the three fundamentals of running a successful business in Uganda? Patrick.
Thank you, Bwana Rugyendo. A good evening to you all. First of all, I'm honored to be here amongst these distinguished people to speak to you. Before I begin actually talking to you or trying to address any of the questions here, I must sincerely, with my hand on heart, thank Sudhir Ruparelia for coming here to be with you tonight. I have been on the circuit for some time, talking especially to young entrepreneurs to encourage them in business. So many times people think, oh, this guy is a role model. Not that I'm a very good businessman, but I'm happy to come out and share the little that I know with anybody who wants to know why businesses fail in Uganda, particularly because the spirit is there. The spirit of entrepreneurship is there. But so many businesses die within the first 5 years. The attrition rate is very high. It's like if you're rearing chicken, and you rear so many chicken, but 85% of them are going to die very soon before they are really productive, then why are you in that business? It's a shame that the spirit is there, and it was actually amplified when the president began this word, kulembeka. Everybody kulembeka. When it rains, put your bucket and get some money. He did a great job, our leader, and people forget. Just like when he was leading the campaign on HIV, we in Uganda didn't realize what he was doing. But the whole world outside recognized him because he did a fantastic job. Whereas other countries were in denial, our president was speaking openly about AIDS and how to confront it and remove the stigma. And nearly every family had this problem. The same thing he did when he tried to sensitize us about entrepreneurship. Everybody in their own ways, even in the village, they want to kulembeka. And I've seen the change. Now I see you here. All of you have come here. And I was like, how did you come here? I'm not getting paid. I don't think Sudhir is getting paid. Anyway, we shall talk about that. But but the point is, you've got to all learn how to make some money. When I go to the village, I was in Ivan at Christmas time, and this everyone was talking about corruption, corruption, corruption. And a person who I respect, an elderly man who lives in the village, came to me, and Mwana Wanje, Patrick, pulled me on the side. Where is this corruption? Give me a little. There's so much corruption in the country. Because then the people in the village, they hear about it, don't know what is corruption, where is the money? But Uganda is dying of corruption, but where is it? If it's a sickness, nanye tubunkwata, you know? So I'm just showing you that there's a big difference out there of what's happening, but I'm glad the entrepreneurship spirit has gripped our country.